Fataya is a Middle Eastern meat pie that can alternatively be stuffed with spinach or cheese such as feta or labneh. It is a part of Arabian cuisine and is eaten in Iraq, Syria, Palestine, Lebanon, Jordan and other Arabian countries. For preparing the spinach fataya, we are first going to prepare the spinach. So here I have got 500 grams of frozen spinach. You may even use fresh spinach, and if you're using fresh ones, make sure that you are chopping the spinach fine. And now I'm adding a half a teaspoon of salt to the spinach. The reason we are doing that is the salt is going to drain out the excess water from the spinach, which will help us to make the fataya very easily. And we are going to let the spinach rest for half an hour. So after resting for half an hour, I'm going to squeeze out all the water from the spinach. As you can see, so much of water is coming out of the spinach in just half an hour. A lot of water has been drained out of the spinach, and this is very necessary even if you're using fresh or the frozen ones, so that it does not make our dough soggy. So in this bowl, the spinach is ready, which I had squeezed out, and the water is over here. So I'm going to discard the water, and now with the help of my hands only, I'm going to separate the spinach and then move on to the next step. So for making the fataya, we are going to need a few things, plus we are going to need the dough. So I have made already a pizza dough recipe, which is on the video, and you will find the link on the video. So here I've made a pizza dough with the help of whole wheat flour, and here I've made with the plain flour. So these things will have to keep it ready. And apart from the spinach that I showed you earlier, we are going to need a few things. So we are going to need a handful of parsley. Then I have got one medium-sized onion, which I have finely chopped. And here, over here, I have got sun-dried tomatoes. If you see, they are available like this in the market, which is preserved in olive oil. So I have just cut them into these small chunks. And if you do not have sun-dried tomatoes, then you can take one large tomato and cut it up, but discard its seed as well as pulp, and then just cut it into small chunks. Apart from that, I'm going to add some jalapenos, which I will be adding separately into the wheat fataya. And then I have got some labneh over here, which is equivalent to like cream cheese, or if you do not have labneh, then you can even use some ricotta cheese. The taste would be same. And then just to spice up the fataya, I'm using a particular Middle Eastern spice called the sumac. If this is not available, you can use lemon juice instead. This sumac has got a tangy taste, so the lemon would taste absolutely perfect. In goes the parsley. Then I'm going to add the sun-dried tomatoes along with olive oil. So in case if you're using fresh tomatoes, then you will have to add in some olive oil. And I don't need to add salt because there is already salt in the preserved sun-dried tomatoes. And now I'm going to add the onions to it. And then you can make this mixture and keep it in the fridge for about 2 or 3 days. It won't spoil. And I'm just going to sprinkle a teaspoon of sumac. And if you want, you may increase or decrease the quantity of sumac according to your taste. And I'm not adding jalapenos right now. I'm going to add it into individual fatayas as per the taste of. Yeah, my both doughs are ready, and you have to preheat your oven at 350 degrees Fahrenheit, which is 180 degrees centigrade. So first we are going to start by dusting my countertop. So make sure that your countertop is clean and free of any dirt. And now we are going to place the dough over the flour, and make sure that you flour your dough very well because we don't want it sticking to the countertop. And with the help of a rolling pin, we are going to roll the dough into a big flat disc or a roti. So this is one of the ways of making the fataya. Like, I make one big disc or a roti, and then with the help of a cookie cutter, you can make small circles. But this is not one of my favorite ways. This is just a way of showing how to make it. So when you're rolling the roti, make sure that it is of even length. And here is one small disc. Into that I'm adding a tablespoon of filling, and you can reduce the amount also, but I like it a bit filling. So now we are just holding it from the center and then pinching at the top, and you can go all the way down and seal it towards the end. Now this other end, you'll just pull it up and then press it in the center and then flatten it out towards the side. So this is how your fatayar should look like. Basically, it should look like a star. This is the other way that, you know, I just divide my dough into equal parts and then roll each part into a big disc, which is the size of my palm. So I like this size because it gives a lot of space for the filling also. And plus, there's no chance of the filling coming out. Once we are done folding the fatayar, we'll place each fatayar over a baking tray which is lined with parchment paper. For the jalapeno filling, we are just adding jalapenos according to the taste, how much ever you want. And also I'm going to add a blob of cheese over this filling, and then we can seal it the way we have sealed the other fatayars. Our spinach fatayas are all ready, and it took me about 20 minutes for this one batch to be baked and be ready. So let me cut one piece and show you from inside. And as you can see, it has cooked very beautifully from down as well, and the fatayar has become soft. And the one which I'm cutting, I have made it with the all-purpose flour dough, and as you can see, the fatayar is dry inside, it is not soggy. So guys, do give it a try, post your comments and share my videos with your family and friends, and do like us on Facebook and subscribe to my channel, and thank you for watching my video.